Good evening. Welcome to the Inclusion Show with Wallace Ford. We're pleased to have you here with us this evening. Remember, the Inclusion Show is the only show that includes you. And now it's time to get busy. We're going to begin with my point of view commentary, which was taken straight from the Point of View blog, which appears twice a week online. You're welcome to read it at your convenience. Today's topic is the real State of the Union. Now, earlier this week, President Obama gave his first State of the Union message in his second term. And millions of us actually listened to his presentation. And of course, there's hundreds, if not thousands, of commentators and pundits and opinion makers who have something to say about what we all just heard. However, this probably is a good time to think about actually what the State of the Union is in these days and times. And as is in the case in many of these instances, there's good news and not so good news. Let's start with the not so good news. It turns out that at this point in this country's history, a very hardcore cadre of right-wing zealots has taken virtual control over one of the two major political parties in this country. And the Teapublican philosophy, boiled down to its basics, is that while they ignore history in the process and ignore reality in the process, it boils down to basically government has no basic role in this country and that it should be eliminated or dismantled whenever and wherever possible. Now, this point of view, of course, neatly obscures some very real realities about why this country is exceptional. Indeed, without things like a free, compulsory, universal public education, a national highway infrastructure, an unparalleled network of public and private higher education institutions, a social safety net, which takes into account issues like food and medical care and housing for a huge segment of this country's population, a relatively reliable system of laws and rules and regulations. Without all of these things, this country would not be exceptional and indeed would be well on its way to third world status. It's just a little bigger than most countries in that category. Now, somehow, the right wing of the right wing has bought into this Ayn Rand grim fairy tale that divides all of humanity into makers and takers. And in this fractured fairy tale, the makers are all self-made men and women who have succeeded by virtue of their skill, their ability, and their superiority, their overall superiority. Now, as of course, they don't explain, of course, how the lights come on and how the water runs in their self-made universe. And the Teapublicans have become so convinced that they are absolutely correct that they're now adopting terrorist tactics. And in the world of the terrorists, the ends justify the means. And so they've employed incredible means, such as insulting the president of the United States at every possible turn, trying to subvert and suppress the electoral process in these United States, and finally, trying to dismantle and fatally damage the economic infrastructure of the United States. So far, let's see what the scoreboard looks like. Well, so far, the insults have fallen short, and President Obama has not dignified the mud that has been slung at him, except, well, there was that time he did barbecue Donald Trump at the National Press Club, but now, can we really blame him for doing that? We have also seen, of course, that during the 2000 election, dozens of states tried to do everything that they could do legally, and sometimes not so legally, to suppress the vote. They were not successful this time, but keep in mind that the Alito, Scalia, Roberts, Thomas cabal on the United States Supreme Court will soon be ruling on the validity and viability of the Voting Rights Act. So it might be time to buckle our seatbelts. Finally, the craziness of the Teapublicans, the absolute madness of the Teapublicans, was cited by numerous scores of financial analysts all over the world as the major reason why the United States credit rating was downgraded for the first time in history in 2011. And now these same Teapublican right-wing zealots are trying to make us believe that doing a flamenco dance on the fiscal cliff is some kind of patriotic strategy, when in fact that strategy is the real job killer in this economy. Now the good news, and there is good news, my friends. The good news is that people who believe in a progressive approach to public policy and the role of government have found a political voice. And that voice does not belong solely to Barack Obama, although he does, we have to admit, make a hell of a lead singer. The last election proved that there are men and women throughout this country who are willing to stand up to the Teapublican bullying, intimidating tactics, and that they're willing to vote for the people that they believe in. And this growing new majority is also not buying the notion that the pseudo-tsunami, which the Teapublican right wing would have us believe is the wave of the future, is indeed the wave of the future. And so, the 2012 election also illustrated, however, that the battle lines are no longer between the red states and the blue states. The battle lines are not even a matter of class, at least not in the traditional sense of the word. The battle lines are between those who believe that government, effective government, is progressive, is compassionate, and is always engaged in perpetual renaissance. And then you have, on the other side, people who believe that Adam and Eve walked with the dinosaurs 6,000 years ago and that government has no real role in American society, unless, of course, they happen to need help. And then they change their tune, if only for a little while. Well, finally, the final good news, however, is while the State of the Union may be a precarious one, the justice, compassion, and a progressive vision of the future will indeed triumph. I certainly believe that, and I hope that you do too. Thank you. And now it's time for From the Heart. Well, you know, we're going to go back. Comedy is one of my favorite areas of inquiry and study, and I've paid attention to humor in all of its forms over the years. Well, there used to be something called comedy teams here in the U.S. Yeah, we can think of the Marx Brothers. Remember Harpo and Groucho and Zeppo and Chico? And then you had the Three Stooges, Larry, Moe, and Curly. We had the Martin and Lewis team. We had any number of comedy teams. And then they kind of faded away. We now see solo comedians by and large. Well, I'm pleased to announce that the Republican Party is in the process of bringing back comedy teams after President Obama made his presentation, his State of the Union address. The Republicans just said, well, it's important that they have a response in place. This has been done traditionally for scores of years at this point. Well, who did they choose? They chose the Rubio Rand comedy team. Which was really quite interesting, as a matter of fact. We had Marco Rubio coming up there looking like he came straight from a student council meeting to somehow put his perspective out there with respect to what the President of the United States said or didn't say. And in the middle, you had to see this to believe it, in the middle of his presentation, he had to take a big drink of water because I guess he was just a little too nervous. And then after that, in an online presentation, because the Senator Rand Paul was just too hot for regular TV, I guess, we had Rand Paul looking like he just had climbed out of somebody's laundry bag to again spew his same right wing Ayn Rand, that of course is where he got his name from, his right wing Ayn Rand rhetoric. Which, of course, has already been rejected by millions of Americans and will ultimately, I think, be rejected by this country as a whole. And so instead of using the occasion of the State of the Union address to offer serious and thoughtful responses to President Obama's presentation, the Republican Party decided to go the comedy route. I want to congratulate them for bringing back the genre of the comedy team. The Rubio Rand comedy team will probably be appearing in a Holiday Inn someplace in your community sometime soon. We wish them all the best. Well, that concludes our program for this evening. We want to thank you so much again for watching the Inclusion Show. We want to, of course, urge you to share the link for this show with your friends and colleagues. And we'll be back next week. And remember, stay strong.